G'day everyone, welcome to Blue Abroad. As we've done all off-season, we've got another player review today. And today is none other than the prodigal son who returned in 2020, Eddie Betts. And how good was it seeing this guy back in navy blue in 2020? As a Blues fan myself, I never thought I'd see the day after he crossed over to Adelaide in 2013. I thought I would never see Eddie back in navy blue doing what he does best, and thankfully we got to see that in 2020. And look, it was done relatively early in the trade period last year. You know, there were murmurs early on that we were interested, and it got us all excited. And to get that done early and get us excited and just G'd up for 2020 to, you know, to see him back was incredible. And then we get to round one and he's done a calf, and it's like, wow. Are we actually going to see Eddie back in navy blue? Like, have we made a mistake? Is he past his prime? He's 33. Soft tissue injuries are not easy to get over. And certainly for me, coming out of round one, you know, it was a 2-3 month injury that would have needed rehab, and I thought there's absolutely no way. And then fortunately, from that perspective, we had the COVID pause and then the restart 3 months later, and gave Eddie time to rehab what he needed to rehab, and he got back into the side instantly against round two against Melbourne, and you know, he opened his account, he reopened his account as a blue, and got me off my couch. I'm sure it got everyone else off their couch when he kicked that goal against Melbourne, and it looked like he'd sort of go on with it from there. And the week after against Geelong, couldn't be understated that he went on with it. By far his best performance of the year. He had that game against the Bulldogs where he kicked four, but in terms of impact and influence and everything that we have come to know about Eddie over the years at both his time at Carlton and at Adelaide, that was all on show. That was on show for everyone. He had three goal assists, he kicked a goal, his tackling pressure, just his pressure off the ball and on the ball was through the roof, and you know, we blew the Cats out in the first three quarters, and a lot of that was due to the work that Eddie was doing forward of centre with that forward group. And then in the final quarter, you know, Geelong were coming, and as a Carlton fan, I'm sure there were so many others out there that were thinking, you know, seen this movie before, like, we know how this is going to work, and it looked like they were going to run over the top of us genuinely. And minute 30 to go, who steps up? None other than Eddie Betts. You know, not in 2020. Maybe in 2019 he would have got us, but not with this guy. Not with this guy on the side. He lays that tackle on Jack Henry, holding the ball, gets the ball inside 50 quickly into our forward 50 to lock it in, and then hard running gets him into the forward pocket, and he ends up with the ball again to finish off the game. So it was incredible to see Eddie back at what I would argue is his best. Is what he, it was his best for this season. And then, although we thought he'd go on with it, it sort of tapered off after that to an extent. When we got to the Gold Coast game up in Darwin, and it was in greasy conditions, and yeah, you know, he kicked a goal, lit up Darwin. It was good to see him putting on a bit of a show. But he could have done so much more, and he was making mistakes that you wouldn't expect Eddie to make. You know, he's dropping sitters on his chest that he would usually swallow up. There were mistakes with fumbling at ground level and whatnot. He was blaming the greasy conditions, but you know, you saw in the weeks after that that it was a similar sort of story in some circumstances, and I was sort of thinking, maybe this is it. You know, maybe he's done. Maybe this is all we've seen. As a Victorian, I genuinely thought I may not be able to see this guy in person again and tear up the MCG. But last week we got that news that he got that, you know, that 1 year contract extension, and I think thoroughly deserved. You know, he had 25 combined goals and goal assists for the year. Phenomenal for someone his age. So he just keeps doing it year after year, being that team player, especially. But it's not just his on-field performance, it's not just his stats that are so valuable to this club. It's the off-field stuff and the energy that he brings and the culture and everything that comes with Eddie Betts. And you heard from Zach Fisher, if you watched his Dylan Friends podcast episode the other week. Him, David Cunningham, Michael Gibbons, he said that they all want to earn the respect of Eddie. And that is massive, massive for guys that age, you know, in the early 20s, mid 20s, that have looked up to this guy growing up. Now to be able to play alongside him, learn his craft, learn what he does, not just on the ball, but off the ball, and how he sees the game, that's huge for us. So another year for Eddie is absolutely deserved. Let me know what you think of Eddie's season. He ticked off a massive milestone in his career by being the first player to kick 600 goals and have 300 goal assists. So massive congratulations to Eddie on that front. He had a phenomenal year for someone his age, for someone that a lot of people thought wouldn't be able to do what he's done. But I'd love to hear everyone else's thoughts on what he did in 2020 and what you think he's going to do in 2021. Because I personally hope he has he takes it to another level in what could be potentially his last season. So let me know your thoughts, guys. I'd love to hear it. And go Blues.